Sally Jones, the reason we got you here, Sally, you actually used to work for our rivals, BBC Breakfast. So lovely to have you on a proper breakfast show. but the reason you're
and
here
and welcome
is...
back to Television Centre.
Yes, exactly.
By the way,
the place where Breakfast used to come out.
Yeah,
so you worked here, in fact.
Yeah,
and to early mornings. I bet when your alarm went off, that took you back, didn't it?
Yes, it really felt like eye bag time.
Well, I remember you well, Sally, for your sports reporting on the BBC, and you had this extraordinary experience. Is why you're here today. You went to Wimbledon and you were just there to watch the tennis. And Meghan Markle was there, the Duchess of Sussex. And she was there with a couple of friends enjoying a nice jolly at the tennis, and that's fine. But you had this extraordinary moment where one of her bodyguards, the special branch guys or whatever they are, came up and tapped you on the shoulder and asked you not to take pictures of it. Tell us in your own words what happened.
Well, what happened? I was sitting just in a section of the stand at Court One, about sort of 15 to 20 seats along from her on a similar row. And there seemed to be quite a lot of people in the crowd photographing somebody. I looked across. I was just photographing Serena Williams. The next thing, little tap on the shoulder, a very, very polite Royal Protection Officer said, would you kindly not take photos of the Duchess? She's here in a private capacity. And I was a bit gobsmacked. I thought, oh, gosh, why upset people? And then suddenly I felt... Well, a bit angry, but a bit sort of bemused. I almost burst out laughing.
And you're a fan of the royal family.
Great
it's not
fan,
like you're anti-monarchy.
But the point was you hadn't been taking photographs.
No, I haven't a single photograph of Meghan. And if I had taken one, it would have been a blurry shot of her left ear.
So those photographs that we've just seen, as you were speaking, were actually taken by photographers there at Wimbledon taking photographs for the papers.
The whole press pack was there. The BBC cameras were going tight on her face. There were about 200 other spectators who turned away from the court to get shots of her.
Yes.
And they were snapping away. I think everybody's Instagram and Facebook was all over Meghan Markle pictures. I wasn't even after.
I am not a big fan of Miss Markle. And I'm particularly not a big fan of the way that she and Prince Harry appeared to want their cake and eat it on privacy. This is not a private visit. If you're the Duchess of Sussex getting a freebie at Wimbledon in the VIP seats, watching your mate Serena Williams with a couple of your friends, it's not a private visit. You're there as a member of the royal family.
When you sat down, were all these seats around her cleared? Or when you were there, had they then put fans back? Because the implication was that there had been a request for her to be sort of isolated, and then she had said, actually, just let everybody come and sit here.
I've no idea about that. I just popped in. I'd got a few guests there, and I just popped in to have a look. It appeared to be fairly clear. I've no idea whether or not they cleared them. But they sometimes will clear a couple of seats, you know, when because 2 days earlier, the Duchess of Cambridge had come.
With all the freebies that come your way from being the Duchess, with the fact the taxpayer pays £2.5 million for your home refurbishment and so on, with the fact the taxpayer is paying for your security guys to be at Wimbledon at not insignificant expense, we pay for that. You put all that together, the deal is... that actually, when you're there, you just, you smile. And people take the picture, that's fine. That's part of the deal.
And it all seemed to be part of that business about the secrecy over the godparents, the trying to prevent the media getting any kind of handle on
it. Not even told where the baby was born or anything like that.
And that business of one moment you're told that Meghan's gone into labour, a few minutes later you're told that the baby was born several hours ago. Mm. And it's as that you almost feel the media and the public who really love that couple are being taken for mugs.
I don't know what they're trying to achieve because, of course, it always has the complete opposite effect to the one they want. They think it's going
to
make people, you know, they can demand this privacy and it'll all be fine. Actually, all it does is antagonise everybody, antagonises the media who feel thwarted and misled, antagonises the public who feel like the royals are part of them.
Look, I'll always defend Meghan Markle, but I do think
odd. Why would you always defend her?
Shall I speak?
Extraordinarily bold, sweeping statement.
But in this situation, I think it's very odd that you can claim that you are somewhere very public where there are photographers, and not just people with iPhones, but actual photographers, and say that you're there in a private capacity, as if you have some sort of invisibility shield that you can place around
you, which is total nonsense.
I just said, you're what, when he said private capacity. There were around 200 ordinary people.
Was he embarrassed, this guy, to even be asking?
He looked a bit embarrassed to me. I mean, I didn't want... I sort of giggled, actually. I was a bit sort of taken aback, and I felt that he was a bit uncomfortable and awkward.
But it's all part of her control freakery about pictures. You know,
Do you think it's her me media team, or do you think it
No, I think it's her, and that's why with the baby, the press weren't allowed in to photograph the christening or the baby or anything like that. She releases these pictures on her Instagram site, normally around the same time Harry is making some speech about the evils of social media. And so the whole thing is riddled, in my view, with hypocrisy. But it comes back to, really, what are they trying to achieve with all this?
But, you know, I mean, you see, for example, so here, I don't mind that they wanted the christening to be private.
Why?
I think
why
the fact...
You? The Archbishop of private people don't have the Archbishop of Canterbury to preside
right,
over their christening.
Yeah, but everything that he does doesn't
christening.
Have to be public.
No, I mean,
so
I
think that if they then release the pictures, then the tabloids get what they want. I
not
think
the tabloids. What did you say? Tabloids.
Yeah, and the newspapers get what they want. The media, the public get what they want. Whatever.
Why should the christening be private?
Because I think that they are entitled to a level of privacy, but what
the
I don't understand...
There.
You've just said that.
How many private people have the Archbishop of Canterbury to preside over their baptism of their child? Nobody.
I still think they're entitled to a level of privacy. What I find is odd is when you claim to be private in public. Mm-hmm. That's my threshold.
If you go to a public event like that at Wimbledon, you know that there are lots of cameras around.
It's very odd.
To ask for privacy.
Odd.
Yeah.
What are the names of William and Kate's godparents for any of their kids?
Don't
Anyone know?
Know? No. So why would you want to know Prince Harry and Meghan's godparents?
Why would you make such a big deal of banning anyone from knowing, given that actually, when the others have said who they are, nobody really cares?
Well, because right? nobody just really cares.
No,
you just proved your point.
No, that's not why they're doing it. They're doing it to exercise a form of weird privacy control over something that they don't need to bother about. But these godparents, whoever they are, it doesn't matter. Nobody really cares
so
that much.
So why would you get worked up about
because
it,
the
then?
Media and the public actually do care when they feel like, well, hang on, why are you not giving us this information? You are public figures. They are.
But their godparents aren't public figures, are they?
Meghan and Harry got given their castle, Frogmore Cottage. It's like this massive thing.
Cottage.
Five homes whacked into one big mansion, right? They were given it by the Queen, so there's no bill for a house.
I think that...
The £2.5 million refurbishment was paid for by the taxpayer.
Yeah.
Right? These are both multi-millionaires, right?
Yeah.
She glad hands off to Wimbledon with a couple of her mates and has a great time clearing all the seats around her and no one's allowed to take her picture.
Yeah.
Right? We're banned from knowing who the godparents are.
We
were banned from
really
knowing
where
she had the baby. We're banned from all these things, but she wants all the good stuff. And she's behaving like a Hollywood actress, which is what actually she is.
The thing is that you criticise her for whatever she does, whereas I'm prepared to allow that there is a...
Well, you defend her for whatever
I
she does.
I think she should have a
level different
of
views
privacy.
About her.
I mean, quite often, royal babies are... I think they're very often a christening shop within Buckingham Palace, and that's not going to be a public occasion, nor should it be. But those nice pictures, which everybody loves to see, and people like me that really follow the royals, love to see a happy shot of mum and baby and
Of course,
father.
Of course.
Everybody around us in Warwick. I'm just an old biddy from the Shires. You know, we all love to.
Right.
We
but
all
my
love
point
to
is, Susanna, you're not, you know, you're a BBC reporter. For a long time.
But a long time ago.
Yeah, I know. But you were for a long time. It's not like you're just some random member of the public who's not used to the way that things at Wimbledon work. As well. You know exactly how it works. You were a sports journalist for the BBC. You weren't even taking her picture. And you were harangued by this royal protection guard.
To be honest, he was extremely polite. I was just astounded that with 200 people all taking her picture from up her nose,
yeah.
that somebody right along the row, not even taking her picture, should have the tap on the shoulder.
My concern is, did you actually get some nice photos of Serena Williams?
I had a beautiful photo of Serena Williams, and I'm the world's worst photographer, and normally they're terribly blurry, and I've got a lovely one of her doing a great big welty kind of serve, so I got just one. The others I destroyed because they were all out of focus.
I mean,